What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, newly crowned WBC undefeated British Lineal Heavyweight World Champion Tyson the Gypsy King Fury is now alluding to in his recent workout video. If you don't know, Tyson Fury does a workout video every single morning with his wife, and he demonstrates, you know, staying in shape. You know, he promotes staying healthy, staying in shape, you know, and things of that nature on his Instagram live every single morning at about 9 o'clock in the UK, right? With that said, to this morning, Tyson Fury did one, and he was doing a little Q&A or responding to some questions. He usually turns off the comment section, in which Tyson Fury is alluding to now that there's a possibility of him having an undisputed mega showdown with fellow countryman, two-time unified heavyweight British world champion Anthony Joshua. We know that MTK Global stepping in and supposed to be, you know, reports were that MTK Global were assisting on the part of Matchroom CEO and promoter Eddie Hearn as Frank Warren. Queensberry Promotions is the promoter of Tyson Fury in the UK. He has two promoters. He has co-promoters. He has legendary promoter, top-ranked CEO and promoter Bob Arum, which Tyson Fury, when he fights in the States, is on ESPN, that network. And in the UK, he has Queensberry Promotions, which is Frank Warren. Frank Warren and Eddie Hearn don't see eye to eye, and they don't have the best of relationships. So there were reports that Tyson Fury needed MTK Global to intervene and negotiate on the part of Eddie Hearn with Frank Warren. And now Tyson Fury is coming out and he's stating that they have huge news coming, massive, massive news. And he's alluding to the possibility of facing Anthony Joshua in the undisputed match. Obviously, we know there's a huge sticking point because former WBC reigning heavyweight world champion Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder has a rematch clause, a trilogy match with Tyson Fury already signed, sealed, and ready to be delivered. The fight was looked to be scheduled for July 18th, but obviously that couldn't take place due to the pandemic and due to the quarantine and the outbreak, right? So all sports have been suspended and put on hold. With that said, Deontay Wilder said he was not willing to take any amounts of step-aside money to allow Tyson Fury and Anthony Joshua to do business. Also, Anthony Joshua has an IBF mandatory challenger for one of his belts. He holds the IBF, he holds the WBO, the WBA, and the IBO world titles. He has a mandatory for the IBF title. It comes in the form of Bulgarian fighter Kubrat Pulev, who's once beaten, lost to Vladimir Klitschko. That was his title opportunity, and he came up short in that fight. And Kubrat Pulev also stated that he was not willing to take step-aside money, any amount of step-aside money, as he's already 30 years of age, and he feels like Father Time is not on his side. His opportunities are slipping away, and he wants to seize the moment and the opportunity to face Anthony Joshua for the title. And he also recently came out and said Anthony Joshua is very weak-minded, and he believes that if he don't get to Anthony Joshua soon, he will lose again before he gets his opportunity, and he wants to be the man to beat Anthony Joshua to strip him of those titles. With that said, Deontay Wilder came out and he said he's absolutely not willing to take step-aside money to see this undisputed match push through. He was clamoring for an undisputed match with Anthony Joshua prior to Anthony Joshua's loss to Andy Ruiz Jr. June 1st in the first fight back in Madison Square Garden in New York, which saw Andy Ruiz drop Anthony Joshua four times and upset him in the seventh round, ultimately stopping him. Anthony Joshua came back, made the necessary adjustments, made Andy Ruiz look absolutely silly, in my opinion, won every single round except for maybe one or two here and there. If you feel generous to give Andy Ruiz a round in that fight, yes, we know Andy Ruiz was not committed. He was not focused. He was not in shape. Nonetheless, that's not Anthony Joshua's fault. He outclassed Andy Ruiz in a rematch and regained his titles, thus seeing him being a two-time unified heavyweight world champion. So now Anthony Joshua and Eddie Hearn have been calling and clamoring and looking to try and push for a fight between themselves and Tyson Fury. But Tyson Fury recently, as they stated, Anthony Joshua and Eddie Hearn, that it would be a massive mega showdown in the UK. Undisputed heavyweight has never been done on UK soil before. But Tyson Fury recently came out and relinquished his United Kingdom boxing license, which means that he's not able to fight in the UK. Frank Warren then came out and stated that the offers are not coming from the UK. It's coming from a Saudi Arabia group that's looking to stage the fight outside of the country. We know with the quarantine and the countries being on lockdown, especially in the United States, it's hard-pressed to see any mega events take place. There was a UFC card in which one of the fighters tested positive in that card for the virus and was sent home. So, you know, it's very dangerous. Massive groups can't gather. You know, there's no gathering with massive groups of people. They're looking to stage sports, you know, are moving forward with no crowd, right? So, and a lot of athletes are opposed to that. Terrence Crawford being one, he said he's not willing to fight in front of nobody in the stadium, especially big fights. So, you know, Tyson Fury and, you know, the rules outside of the country, United Kingdom and the United States may be different. So maybe in Saudi Arabia, they allow massive gatherings of groups of people, you know, to have big events and still stage these types of fights. And we know that they have the money to pay for them. But like I said, Deontay Wilder said that he's not willing to take step aside money. Kubrat Pulev then came out and said that if Deontay Wilder, he had a change of heart. He said if Deontay Wilder is to take step aside money and they offer him the right amount, he is willing to take step aside money as long as he's able to get his opportunity to fight for the title immediately following the undisputed bout. Now, the thing is, unless you hear from Deontay Wilder, who says that he's absolutely not taking the step aside money, and the fight became personal as new evidence and things came out about Tyson Fury and the glove situation with Deontay Wilder. Deontay Wilder is taking the fight as absolutely personal. It's not just competition anymore, and he's not willing to take step aside money. He absolutely wants to get and rectify the situation with Tyson Fury. So he's not willing to do so. So I cannot truly see how this is going to come to pass unless, like I stated before, they're citing that Deontay Wilder's injury because he suffered a torn bicep in the fight with Tyson Fury leading up into that fight, and he had surgery on it. So unless Tyson Fury and his team are seeking a way out of the contract due to Deontay Wilder being unable to perform due to the injury, and they're looking to be able to have an interim fight to be allowed to still, you know, stay active, you know, citing that he needs to stay active and his career is being on hold or something of that matter, I truly can't see this fight coming to fruition. So let's see what the massive news that Tyson Fury is talking about. He, like I said, he alluded to MTK Global coming to a deal and having massive news coming very, very soon. So let's see how this all plays out. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. And another thing is, I can see Deontay Wilder possibly saying, listen, if they pay him a massive enough money, you know, he'll take it. And he's still going to immediately face the winner of that fight. And I truly believe that he still will get his opportunity against Tyson Fury because I feel like Tyson Fury is going to beat Anthony Joshua. I think he just has the style. It's a bad style matchup for Anthony Joshua. He's too quick. He's too savvy. And I think that Tyson Fury is still going to win the fight. So I believe that if Deontay Wilder did possibly take the step aside money, which I don't believe he will, but just saying if he did, it would still be an undisputed match for Deontay Wilder, and it would still be against Tyson Fury. So he's in a win-win situation either which way it go, in my opinion. But obviously, we have to see how this plays out because, you know, like I said, Deontay Wilder's not into playing games. He's not into dealing with Eddie Hearn and Matchroom. So if Anthony Joshua was to win the fight, then that would be a tough sell. he would have to jump through hoops to get Anthony Joshua in the ring, so on and so forth, and he's just not willing to do so. I don't know if he's willing to run the risk of Anthony Joshua possibly winning a fight and then him having to go through Anthony Joshua to get the titles back and then possibly try to get a deal done to sign to fight Tyson Fury. And then what if Anthony Joshua, they're both champions, him and Fury, what if they have a rematch clause? Then he have to wait, sit out two fights. So I don't know how that would play out, but let's just see how this all plays out. But like I said, that's all I got for y'all, man. It's your boy Blue signing off. Peace.